struggling with target selection and snapping, unsure how to align your 3D objects perfectly? Then, welcome to the ultimate tutorial that will make your snapping skills go through the roof and become a snapping master. In this video, we're going to explain about target selection in Blender to make your modeling process a breeze. So buckle up, grab your mouse, and let's start blending. This video is the third part of the snapping tutorial. In case, if you haven't watched the last two videos, I'd really suggest to first watch those to have a better understanding of this video. First, what exactly are non-selectable objects? As the name implies, these are the objects that cannot be selected. In that case, how do we even make the objects non-selectable? It's simple. To do so, click this filter icon and then toggle this little arrow. This option controls whether or not you can select an object. Turn this on to make the object selectable and off to make it non-selectable. Now, you're able to locate a button called Exclude Non-Selectable in the snapping menu. With this feature disabled, you can really snap the selected object to the non-selectable target object. However, with switched on, you are no longer able to snap onto that object. Following that, we'll go over another essential feature called Align Rotation to Target. This option allows rotation to the selected item while snapping onto the target object, depending on the type of Snap To option we have selected. Essentially, the basic idea is that the selected object's Z-axis will remain parallel to normal of whatever Snap To option we are in. For example, if vertex snapping is chosen, the Z-axis of the selected object will align with the normal of the vertex being snapped to. Similarly, edge snapping will align the Z-axis with the normal of the edge being snapped to. And face projection will align the Z-axis with the normal of the face being projected onto. Another interesting feature is the back face culling. So does anyone happen to have idea how this tool works? Essentially, this tool prevents snapping from occurring on the back-facing geometry. When you turn off this functionality, you can see this cube snapping onto the edges of the target object, which is hidden from view. To properly visualize this, switch to wireframe mode. However, if you have it enabled, it prevents the selected object from snapping to those edges. It's worth noting that if you change your field of view to face those edges, you can snap to those targets, but you can't snap to the side that's back-facing from this point of view. You can also achieve this result by recalculating the normals of a face. If we go to Viewport Shading Properties here, we can notice another back-face culling. You might be wondering, what is the difference between these two? Let's explore this further. If you get into Edit Mode and select some of the faces, then press Shift plus N. This will recalculate the normals of all chosen faces, which you can set to facing inside. You can visualize this using the face orientation button in the viewport overlays. The blue ones are all facing out, whereas the red ones are all facing in. Now, you'll notice that we've completely hidden our cube. This is because this option actually hides all the inward-facing faces from visibility. If you turn it the other way around, you can see the cube. These faces exist here as well, which are facing outdoors from this point of view. This option also avoids snapping from occurring because it absolutely hides it from visibility, which eventually results in no snapping at all. If you choose to enable face project snapping, you will come across an option labeled Project Individual Elements. By default, only the snap with point is snapped to the target, and the rest of the selection follow along while maintaining its original shape. However, with this option, each object in object mode will snap independently to the target. In edit mode, every vertex of the selected object will snap based on the point of view, potentially altering the selection's shape. If you choose to use volume snapping, you will notice an additional option called Snap Peel Object. Before delving into how this tool works, it's important to understand the mechanics of volume snapping. Imagine you want to place a cube inside a large cylinder from a particular viewpoint. How does Blender know where to position the cube within the cylinder? To simplify this concept, let's imagine the cylinder is transparent like glass. If you shine a ray of light through it, the first and last points of contact with the cylinder will be marked. When you move the cube within the cylinder, Blender calculates the midpoint between these two contact points and places the cube there. However, what happens if there is a plane in the trajectory path or if the second point of contact is removed? In the former case, Blender will consider the plane as the point of contact and place the cube in the middle as previously discussed. In the latter case, the cube will remain at the first point of contact, since it is technically both the first and last point of contact. Now, what if there are multiple objects in the trajectory path? Blender will only consider the first and second points of contact. This is where the Snap Peel Object tool comes in handy. This tool bridges the gaps between the first and last points of contact in the path and snaps the selected object between these two points. You can find a tool called Snap to Same Target in Face Nearest Snapping Mode. What this tool does is, if you have two objects intersecting each other, and a third object gets snapped to one of these cubes by Face Nearest Mode, normally when you snap it will jump to the nearest face from that point. But with this tool, it will restrict that movement within the first target object. It won't let it snap to the other object at the intersection. When in edit mode and utilizing the snapping feature, there are three additional options available to you. The first option, include active, permits you to snap onto the very object you are currently editing. The second option, include edited, allows you to snap to any objects present in edit mode, even if multiple objects are being edited simultaneously. Lastly, the include non-edited option enables you to snap onto objects that are not currently in edit mode. So there you have it, folks. These are some of the most essential features you should know about when it comes to snapping in Blender. If you feel you need to learn more about Blender, you should watch our video about mastering the 3D cursor. If you have any questions or feedback, feel free to leave a comment down below. Thanks for watching and happy blending!